Hey everybody, Jang here with a look at a Lego Creator 3-in-1 set. This is the Red Go Kart, and this is the Red Go Kart build of the Red Go Kart set. So we'll be looking at the other two builds in the same video as well. First impressions from me, this thing looks really, really good. I like it. This comes with 106 pieces, so modest in size, not one of their smaller, or not one of their smallest ones, but certainly not too big. Got the nice low profile engine back there. Not the best detail there, but I do appreciate the angled exhaust outlets there. It's got nice proportions to it overall. The seat is really nice. The seat looks comfortable and appropriate. And one thing that's especially cool about this, for its size and for its simplicity, it does have working steering. So you can turn the steering and you can turn the steering. It's perfect rack and pinion little action. It's got a little bit of actual play in there, vertical play. Doesn't really affect anything in a negative way. So in all, this one to me just works out really well. You pretty much can see everything there is to see about it just from this angle, just from looking at it. So let's go ahead and move on to the next build in the line. All right, a quad ATV. Not too bad, not too shabby. The fork is not quite the way I would like to see it, the whole steering column. But beyond that, they did get the bars angled back, and it's got kind of the right stance. It's kind of a streeted out quad, I would say. It's too bad that they don't have any figures that will fit this, because you know quads look much better with somebody actually on them. Yeah, I got some detailing around the back, a little bit of a dash detail up there. You got your exhausts. This makes sense to me. You know, I usually really detest seeing Technic holes, pin holes left open on the sides, but here that actually adds a little bit of texture in there, which I think is a lot better than having a solid piece there. So doesn't bug me. Yeah, only just this little area right in here bugs me a little bit. You can angle this forward and back a little bit, but certainly you want it to be angled back as far as it'll go. But yeah, it's a different thing. You can tell what it's supposed to be. So yeah, I think that worked out. Okay, let's check out build number 3. Forklift. You gotta admit this is an exceptionally wide forklift, but that really doesn't bug me. I think that's a good use there of these Technic brick pieces, showing a little bit of just texture on the side, because those aren't always solid. Thing looks sporty. Like a racing forklift. How about that for a concept? Look at those exhausts out the back. They're kind of sleek lines of the whole thing. I think it's pretty fun looking. And it does have a slot where you can put an operator there. And it fits a minifig. You can be sitting back or you can be sitting up like that. Kind of a funny thing if you want to do that. And this actually has a couple of actions to it, surprisingly. You can raise the forks. Well, you can't raise them straight up, but you can angle the whole thing back. Look at that. That's cool. Just a little bit of room for movement there, so you actually could pick some things up with that. It doesn't stay up, but you know, just hold it with your fingers. So it's just a thing to actively play with, and it still has steering like the original build, and it's at the back where it's supposed to be for a forklift. So that's perfect. So another really nice build, really nice use of parts, very creative thing to change this into. I like it. I like this set. I like the parts it comes with. I feel like it's very useful. I feel like it's very playable. I feel like it's very customizable. And the specific builds that they recommend are good and solid through and through. Please share your thoughts about this set down in the comment section and let us know which is your favorite build out of these three. Thanks for watching. I'll be talking to you again soon.